Hey, Crips here, and thank you for joining me yet again. All right, we're in the 64-bit version now, and it's all fantastic. It has the power to work with as much RAM as your system has, but I'm still getting a lot of people emailing me saying my clips just won't play properly. They're choppy and they're laggy in the timeline, and I'll show you what I mean. Here we go. All right, this is the problem. Everybody's emailing me having this problem here. This is an Ultra HD clip, 1920 by 1080. Bit rate is over 10,000, so it's a really, really high definition video. By the way, I didn't show you this in the review, but you can review or view your clips in HD or non-HD. Quite honestly, if your clip is HD, does it make a difference? I don't think so. All right, that's just my personal opinion. Now, how do I fix this? So I tell people when they email me, make sure you have enable smart proxy set up. So settings, see, I don't have enable smart proxy ticked. Some people are saying, I have it ticked, but it's still crap. What's going on? All right. I reply then saying, do you see the smart proxy icon on your clip? And they go, yes, there. No, that is not your smart proxy icon. That is your video clip icon. Smart proxy icon will create another icon right next to it. So what I need to do is then create a smart proxy. So let's do that. Let's go into settings, and I'm going to enable smart proxy. So now it's going to create a draft version of it. I can also force it. So I can go to create smart proxy file. Here it is here, and I go select, which I have done, and press OK. Now it still won't play properly. Watch. All right, still crap. Why? Because it's now compressing. Let's go into smart proxy, queue manager. See, here it is. It's still going through the whole process of creating the smart proxy file. Until you see a little icon on your clip, you're still playing the original clip. So let VideoStudio process it. Now, the bigger the specs on your computer, the faster this will go, okay? So that's what your problem is. You're not allowing VideoStudio to create this file. And then once it has created the file, a little icon will appear, and once that icon appears, you're good to go. You can go and play with your clip, add filters, because it's always going to be in a draft version. And I'll show you what I mean. I have my media info here. I'm going to pull both of them up. All right, so while that's rendering, I can talk. This is the specs on my clip, right? 400 megabytes, 103 megabyte bit rate. So that's a big bit rate, right? Now, once I have finished with my draft version, this is the spec of my draft version. Look at this, 8 megabytes and only 2000 kbps bitrate. So I'm talking about a really, really small file. And it doesn't matter, because when I rendered this out, it will go back to the original source file and use that to do the output, which is this one here, okay? All I'm doing here is creating a proxy. And a proxy is probably about a quarter of the original version. So I hope you understand this. Let's just go back and let's see how far we are with the queue manager. Okay, so it's, as you can see, it's gonna take a while, because this is a pretty big clip that I'm using here, 400 megabytes, and I'm compressing this all the way to 8. Now, if you don't want it that small, you can go into settings, and let me just close this. Go into settings, go into your preferences, go into your performance. All right, now you have an option here, auto generate. This is normally ticked by default. I would recommend it unticking and setting up your own template. By default, it will use an AVI format, and it will create a proxy template by 720 by 480, right? I'm gonna tell VideoStudio, no, whenever I want a proxy file, I want you to use my settings. You can go to template, add and remove, and create your very own template. And then you just add to it here. So I'm going to close this. You'll see that my template's already been added. I called it HD, and this is the settings here. Your settings will probably look like this. See, AVI format. And AVI for me is, I hate AVI wrappers. They still produce a very large file. Okay, I'll show you what I mean. This is the AVI wrapper. It produces a file of 118. This is my template, the MP4 template, and it makes a file of 8. So it's still a huge difference, right? Let's go back into Video Studio. It should all, yep, okay, we're done. Now, if you want me to make a tutorial to show you how to do the templates, just put a comment down below, and if there's enough people, then I'll do that as well. All right, so now I have this icon enabled. Let's have a look at my settings. Yes, it's enabled. Now watch this. Voila, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. That's your problem. If you're having issues with it, make sure you have this little icon on this clip here, and then you're able to play that clip effortlessly in Video Studio. And if you want, you can still preview it in HD. That's what the little icon here is for. I hope that really helped a lot of people out. And as always, thanks for watching.